The scripture for the third reading is John chapter 19, verses 23 through 27. When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says. They divided my clothing among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots. And that is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to the mother, "Woman, here is your son." And he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. No matter the pain, no matter the embarrassment, no matter the indignity, no matter the social stigma just cast on her family, Mary, mother of Jesus, could not be kept away from the crucifixion of her firstborn child. In fact, three Marys, mother, aunt, and friend, positioned themselves to be as near the cross as the soldiers would permit to witness the impending death of one whom they each loved. Whatever comfort and companionship they could provide to Jesus throughout this ordeal, to his death they were willing to provide. Did the soldiers know who they were? Did they even care? Weeping women at crucifixions were commonplace, and the woman posed no real threat of challenging the authority of the soldiers who were simply carrying out their duties. Since crucifixion meant a slow, agonizing death for the poor soul hanging on the cross, the soldiers needed something to pass the time during the boring hours, perhaps days, it took for the life of the condemned to drain away. Casting lots for the few meager possessions of the person on the cross was one of the activities used to relieve an otherwise boring death watch. Jesus, looking down, saw his mother below him. As the firstborn in his family, he still had a family obligation to provide for the care of his mother. With a tone of authority, he directed his mother to embrace a new son. To the disciple whom he loved, standing quietly next to her, he presented a new mother. Jesus still had the time to focus on his human love for both by presenting them to each other in a new relationship. Consider this: because Jesus had other brothers and sisters, was it necessary for him to entrust the care of his mother to someone outside the family? If Jesus had not provided for his mother from the cross, would that responsibility be assumed by a sibling who was not the traditional heir? Thank you.